How's it going, guys? It's Poetry Set, and welcome back to another episode of the multiplayer mini campaign in Europa Universalis 4 with Jack. How you doing, Jack?
I'm doing well. What's going on?
Not much. Just beating up Holland, poor two-province minor in Europe.
Oh, wow. I have claims in both their provinces already. I didn't realize.
You want to help me? No. I mean, you could take.
They have no allies, right?
No. But hey, but you should wait till I finish my war though, so I can like have enough war score to peace out.
Yeah.
it's not like it's gonna get any harder. After this. Wait, where is their capital?
Zealand.
No, I don't think so.
I thought it was.
No, it's not.
I don't know.
Wait. Whoa. Where?
It is.
Oh my God!
Barbados?
It's. Yeah, it's Barbados, and
right, well, that's probably where their army is.
Yeah, and my colonial nations just wiped them out. I zoomed over there just in time to see them finish the siege.
Yeah, same.
That's hilarious. Well, right, okay, well. I guess I didn't need to worry about this anyway. I have 66% war score.
Nice. All
right, what can I take from you, buddy? I want this. I want that. I want this. Give me this. Give me that. I want all of your colonial land, basically. This, give me that one. Yep, I want that island and that island. I just hope I don't have any rebels. But let's see, they're German culture, right?
Yeah.
And German culture is one of my accepted cultures. And they
you
are...
should be fine, then.
Yeah, hopefully. Okay, I can't take this.
I wonder if you'll kick them back into Europe.
I'm gonna take their capital, so yeah, it should.
Yeah, I hope it does.
Yeah, it should.
Because I guess when I took Holland, it kicked them out, which is weird.
I need like 10 more war score, and then I can get everything I want. And then they'll be back in,
It'd be helpful for me for them to be back in Europe.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I understand. After I do this, I think I will actually fulfill my goal of having everything be... No! No! You little wankers.
What happened?
Go look at, like, the bend in Africa, like, you know, near where Benin is. And look who colonized there. Who is colonizing
Is that
there.
Denmark? The orange one?
No, the blue one.
Oh, the like, creek.
Yeah. Nice. No, the creek are... I'm gonna... No, creek, this is not acceptable. You think this is acceptable, creek? No, it is not.
They probably do think it's acceptable.
Yeah, I'm basically going to go to war with them and then take all of the Caribbean that they own, too, because they own a chunk of that now. They took it from the Aztecs.
Fuck, I just lost my claim on Zealand. Are you serious?
That's not good.
Yeah, it's annoying. It's fine, though.
I think I will... no, let's just wait a sec. Come on, get this siege. Get this siege so I don't have to develop any more land. I want to spend it on coring. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Oh, no, not that time. Well, I mean, this war has, like, been pretty easy.
Yeah.
No, it's not really been hard at all.
Cologne, right, under Savoy.
Rio Branco.
Gallery's only allied with Luxembourg? Well, I guess I'll fabricate on them.
Poor little dudes.
Right?
So, I was gonna say, I don't remember. Oh no. Oh, Dookie. Dookie. Cybum, so do you watch, Oh no, I lost 1,000 sailors. Whatever will I do?
Oh no.
I'm gonna pause real quick because I'm gonna peace out of this. Right. The game is getting a little laggy. I think it's because probably.
Is it?
Yeah, well, like, it's a little bit input delay. It's not actually laggy.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I think it's just because of reasons.
Yeah, probably.
You know, we're getting later into the game. There's more stuff going on, but it's not too bad, though. Alright, I want... Ugh, gosh, I want all of your colonial land. That one, that one. That one. That one. That one. That one. That one. Not Zealand and Utrecht. Actually, I want everything besides... Yeah, all right. I'm going to take all the provinces except Zealand and Utrecht.
Nice.
So have fun with a much weakened Holland.
Yep.
Let me go ahead and get my war reps too. And I'm gonna peace out. Cool.
No diplomats to send. Do I need a claim on Zealand? How much would it take? 25? Alright, I guess I'll wait.
German. Most of this land is German, so I think it'll be pretty easy to incorporate.
Yeah.
Which is lovely. One of them is not, but... Yeah, they all have about 10 unrest, which is about what I would expect. So that's good. I probably won't have any rebels, unless something bad happens, but... Let's just raise autonomy, honestly. I don't really care. I don't think I've done that
once this game.
Raise autonomy?
Yeah, I think I lowered autonomy once to provoke a rebellion.
Yeah, somewhere. Sometimes that's good, but then they always come back a second time if you do that, though.
Yeah, but, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Sometimes you just want to get it over with already. Like, especially if you're about to go to war, and you're like, alright, let's just handle this.
I have a lot of... Wow, I have a plus 125 settlers a year. That's a lot.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I didn't realize it was that much. Yeah, I think I can... It's going to get even higher, too. In fact, actually, I don't need my diplo points for that much, and I'm almost the cat. let's use this policy that gives me plus 20.
Yeah?
Yeah, that seems really good. And then, oh my god, I have a whole bunch of good stuff, actually. I forgot, because I finished my thing, I think.
Your thing?
Yeah. So now... Oh my god. This is crazy. Should I do this one? No, I still have a military ID in the works, so let's not do that one yet.
Alright, now I'm going to declare war on Holland.
Yeah, it should literally take, like, 6 months.
Probably wipe them off the map. I think their forts are probably reinforced.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Can I see their garrison? Oh, they actually haven't all the way.
Utrecht hasn't, but...
Well, yeah. Zealand has, but yeah. Let's see if I can handle it just like this.
Do I have any unrest with anyone in Europe? No. Most of it was with just Holland. Holland could join a coalition against me. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Well, I'm able to siege both of their provinces. We'll just sit like that with half stacks.
All right, I'm about to build, like, 10 heavies, I think.
Feels good.
I'm making a template of 10 heavies, and I'm probably going to build a few of these in the near future. First one, build in Barcelona. Mm. Let's see. Yeah, basically, I think I'm going to go to war with the Papal State. Which is going to be interesting. Yeah. We'll just say that.
I mean, who are their allies?
Jamalids, Tuscany, or Lombardy, or someone. I don't know.
Who cares?
Yeah, like, it's not that big a deal. Oh my god, I forgot my heir is really good. My leader needs to die so I can get my heir. He's a 3-5-6 with years of separatism -5. It's real good.
My heir is a 6-3-0, so I really don't want them. But there's like, I can't do anything about it.
Yeah.
So
I'm exploring the world for us, by the way, because you can't see China, right?
No.
Okay. Also, Mongolia is like real big.
Yeah, they've been expanding.
I think so.
It's good to hear.
It looks like it. They're pretty big. But they're not actually a great power, so I think lots of it is probably just empty land. Man,
I want France's heir. Can I support France's heir? Because their heir for me is good.
The answer is no. No, just kidding.
Yeah, I know I can't. You're right.
Darn.
I wish I could, though.
But aren't you, like, royal married to them?
Yeah. But I can't support their heir for me.
Yeah, it makes sense.
And I don't have enough prestige to make my heir the top choice. So.
Yeah. I think I've done fairly well in this campaign so far, but I think we both have.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially after we both, like, had those, like, the second session, it was just like, oh, we shouldn't have declared those wars.
Yeah. Yeah, we had that one rough part of EU4.
Yeah.
And then we both got through it.
Yep.
Yeah, because, like, that was... Because you had to give up Savoy. Now, Savoy is decent strength now, but...
Yeah.
You know, I'm kind of glad that you did... That you lost them, though, because otherwise you would have been interfering with my area.
I would have been a lot stronger for the entire time. So I'm still sad that I lost them.
I'm not so sad.
I would have been. I might have been emperor more, but I've had a lot of female heirs, so maybe not.
Yeah.
That's the thing that's annoyed me the most about this campaign, I think, is that I was converted with government type.
Yeah.
I probably could have edited the save file to change it, but it's not a huge deal.
Oh no, my queen died.
Aw.
Queen consort, rather, but still. Rest
in. Would have been nice to be made an elector as well.
Yeah.
But, whatever.
Tech time. Because
then I could be a kingdom instead of a duchy.
It is tech time, by the way.
Oh yeah, it is. And I have the points for it.
It just became tech time.
Yeah. I have the points for all three. Wow, yeah. That's rare.
For each of them, they were like 470 points, which is ridiculous.
And I probably still have enough admin to core both of these provinces because I have a 6 admin ruler right now.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna not have to deal with rebels from that war at all, which is nice.
That's really good.
Yeah. Especially because they're on islands like halfway across a continent, each of them. Yep. They're in ridiculously far away places from each other.
Alright, well, we took Zealand.
Okay, so this is the node. The node that I really need is Malacca.
Yeah, that's
a really good one.
Alright, and let's pause because we took the rest.
Apparently, it's Syak is there, allied with the Mamluks. Yeah.
Wait, I could vassalize them still?
What?
How?
No.
How could I vassalize them still? It's 2% war score, so like...
What do you mean?
What? But I can't take the... Oh, they have Wampanoag.
Wampanoag?
Where's that?
That's in Massachusetts.
That is Massachusetts.
Yeah.
I can't take it because I can't core it.
That's funny. So they must have just sent that because I didn't have it as an option.
Yeah, they're still... Yeah. Well, I wonder what'll happen if... I guess they'll still exist. Just as that one province.
Yeah.
Well, have fun. I'll force your religion because it's not going to cost much. And you'll give me all the money you have, which isn't much. And... I don't really want you as a vassal, so...
No, I don't really need to do this anymore, do I?
End your rivalries, so I get prestige because I need it. Alright, send an offer.
I think I'm gonna, beat up the Papal State in a second, so that's fun.
Yeah, not a bad idea.
Yeah.
Alright, now let's get these things coring.
Ooh! The Papal State is actually in a war with France right now.
Ooh.
Why? And why do I have a truce with you, Papal State?
You don't. You have a truce with Sicily and Tuscany.
It says I would be breaking a truce. What? Why? I have a truce with Sicily and Tuscany. You are... Yeah. I think this is, not right. This is, bugged or something. It says breaking truce. I definitely do not have a truce with the Mr. Papal State. Not sure about that.
Who do you have truces with? Probably a lot of people.
Only Sicily and Tuscany. Oh wait, no, I'm looking at them. Wait, who do I have truces with? That's
Denmark, Bulgaria, Teutonic Order, Brandenburg, Meissen.
I do.
The Papal State.
That's strange because it doesn't list it for them.
They don't have a truce with you.
Weird. Maybe that's because of that. Maybe that's what the break alliance thing does. That's really strange, though. Why would it only show it one way?
Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah.
Usually truces are mutual in this
game.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah, me neither. I didn't. Apparently, that might be a thing. Maybe that's why we had the confusion regarding the break alliance thing.
Maybe.
Yeah, but that's. I mean, that's just weird.
It is. I agree.
But whatever. Can we upgrade our heavies? Yeah, upgrade them. Yeah, there we go. Upgrade the heavies. Can we upgrade our war galleys? Yeah, do that. Cool. I'm busy upgrading my ships and stuff. We don't have a dockyard here. Where do we have a dockyard? Tarragona. Alright, go to Tarragona. for cheaper repairs. Go to Tarragona.
Alright, let's see. Who can marry that I'm not married to right now?
Oh, I have a colonist! They're not doing anything! No! No! I always forget. Send there. Do it. Yeah, whatever. Just go colonize. I hate this. Truce with Brandenburg has ended. Lovely. So, June of 97, so 6 months. Not too long. And then I will eat you, Mr. Papal State. Rusalon. Mauritius?
Someone's voting for Provence.
That's really funny, especially since I took Provence, the province.
Yep. Who died?
Whoa.
What? Oh, my prince consort died. Who cares?
Is Byzantium growing? Did they take some Salerno land back? Or is that just me?
I'm not sure.
They're definitely, like, long-term they've been shrinking, but...
Yeah.
I feel like they might actually be growing a tiny bit, though. Like, they might have regained some land. Cool.
What? Lombardy is calling me into a war already?
Ooh, against who?
France.
Ooh. Well, then...
Nope.
You made Franconia into a march. Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you feeding them any land?
No, not right now.
They'll probably just give it back anyways, you know?
Yeah, probably.
That's funny. Yeah, so like I think I'm probably just gonna like beat up the Pope. Sorry, Poper man, but like, you know, I'm Protestant. I hate you now, so. Let's go to the South Indian Ocean, I assume. That's, like, Australia. Also, I'm really pissed off. Apparently the Ayyubids are colonizing.
Nice. That's really cool. I like the... Like, I know, like, that it's irritating for you, but I like the variety of people who have been colonizing in this game.
Yeah, it's been interesting. It's people that you wouldn't expect, necessarily. But then some people you would expect, I suppose. But...
Yeah.
Which is cool. Like, some people that wouldn't normally... be expected to colonize are colonizing because of the fact that of their position, which is nice. So they're actually, you know, learning, being smart. Like Creek, for example. I don't know. Although, let's see. Yeah, for Creek, it's actually pretty smart because they're in the Caribbean node, and they're colonizing Ivory Coast. Ivory Coast can go to the Caribbean. Although that's normally not where it goes. But still. How long does my claim here last? Ooh, okay, I got like 6 years to do this, huh? Ooh, it is time. It has become time to do this war.
Has it?
Japan discovered! I found Japan.
Hey. Alright. Gallery, who are your allies? Right, just Luxembourg? I can take Luxembourg. Luxembourg's been half-sieged by rebels for years. I think I'm gonna do that.
Hold on, right, I'm gonna pause in a second.
Alright.
To preview this war. Basically, I am going to smash the crap out of the Papal State. And I'm gonna have to beat I'm gonna have to beat up Savoy and the Jamalids too. Who cares?
Yeah, not a big deal.
Does Savoy have any good allies now? Let's see. They are. No. They're leading a personal union with,
They're allied with you.
Yeah, that's fine. I don't care. I'm breaking two alliances with this. One with the Jamalids, one with Savoy, so that's fun.
Do you have diplomatic ideas?
No.
Oh. Well.
No, yeah.
Goodbye admin points, I guess.
What do you mean?
It costs stability.
No. I mean, that's what I mean.
Oh, you're just breaking the... I get it.
Yeah, like, they're gonna defend...
I get it.
The Papal State. Yeah. Alright, cool. Let's do it. I mean, my navy is, like, real strong. I got 11 heavies, 33 barks or whatever, and then 16 war galleys, so it's probably good enough. And 30 transports, so I can transport a whole 30 stack at once.
I'm gonna continue my policy of picking on the little guys in just a little bit.
Yeah, mostly it's just I really, really want some trade power, and the only way to get, like, more trade power, and the way to get more trade power at this point is to take Rome or Naples, so.
Yeah.
And I have claims on both of those, so we'll see if I can take them. Probably will not be able to. Not both. One of them, sure, but... Alright, let's go and siege him down. I'm already in Rome, basically. Basically, with the Jamalids, I'm just gonna be like, you know, like... I'm just gonna not let them attack me.
I do have to say, it's, like, really nice to be able to... not have to call allies into every war.
Yeah, yeah, once you're strong enough, like, that's one of the things that sucks about the early game of this game. It's like, you can't do anything on your own.
To be fair, I did just declare war to one province minor and their two province minor ally, but, you know, it's fair.
Yeah.
It's a fair fight, I promise. Truce with Denmark ended. Fuck yeah. I've got claims on two of their provinces now.
So many truces ending from the war.
Yep.
14-6-10. 14-6-10. Okay, 14. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. Cool. My land is getting sieged down. I don't much appreciate that.
Who's there?
People.
I can't see your land.
Savoy, Brandenburg, Alsace. A lot of people. Don't worry about it, though.
That makes sense. I guess Savoy would have an easy time getting there.
Yeah, and Brandenburg is already down here too, which is annoying, right. But...
I guess I'll finally take care of these Puritan heretics in Luxembourg.
Yeah.
Finally.
I mean, if they want to mess with me, you guys, you scrubs, come at me. Come at me, honestly. I dare ya. I freaking dare ya. I mean, like... I don't think there's much risk of me losing this war. It's mostly just if I play smart enough to have minimal losses or not.
Luxembourg wants to peace out. I've got a claim on one of your provinces, though.
Is Savoy in any other wars? No. I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to take both of these provinces. I could just look. Let's look. Oh, yeah. No, definitely not going to be able to do that. I could definitely take one, though. So I'll take Rome, probably. But Naples, we'll have to wait. Which one is actually more development? I'm assuming it's Rome. No. Naples won by 1 point. Oh! Hold on. My king died, which is good.
Oh.
Oh god, my new heir is awful though. But but this king is 3-5-6, so that's good. 9 pretender rebels and Teruel. Where's Teruel?
Yo, I just took 671 gold from Gelry in this beast deal.
Nice.
Also, that's pretty good. Luxembourg, I know that I like forced you to close two alliances and give me money, but I also killed. You haven't been able to. You better fucking be happy. I also didn't take any of your land. Mostly because it would have been too much aggressive expansion. Actually, that's the only reason. This coastline project's coming along.
The what?
The coastline project is coming along.
Oh, like expanding your coastline?
Yeah, look at it.
Yeah, soon you'll actually have a decent navy.
We have 19... I have 21 boats.
Yeah. Somehow. I won the Siege of Naples. Now for the Siege of Rome.
All right, let's see.
The game is, like, chugging right now. Probably because I'm in a fairly large war.
Might be the war. I mean, there's you can a go lot to speed of... two if you want.
No, that's fine. There's a lot of moving parts. Oh, I should probably go stop Brandenburg from sieging out my capital, huh? Cool.
Yeah, probably.
It's a level 1 fort.
You should definitely upgrade that.
Yeah, I definitely need to.
Speaking of which, that's what I'm going to do with my, with what I won.
Not a good idea. I'm an idiot, but, you know.
I can build 19 more troops.
Ow. No, they're attacking me in the hills. Oh, God, what's happening? 23rd of November. Run. Alright, can we go down to speed 2 for a little bit? It's going really fast for me. I don't know why it's going so fast on speed 3. Normally it doesn't go this fast. But I can't handle it right now, I will admit. You do not siege down my capital. I siege down your capital. Oh, Savoy! You want to fight, Savoy? You want to freaking fight? You want to fight, Savoy? Alright, that's fine. I just finished sieging down Rome, so now I'm going to siege the rest of this stuff and then come over there and smack you. Oh my gosh. I mean, a lot of my country is sieged down above the Pyrenees, but that's okay. I am losing money, but not a lot. Oh yeah, I'm definitely glad we're on speed 2. I could not handle that pace. Really? You're going to come attack a 45 stack of my troops across a river with half that number? Good idea, Savoy. What does your troops look like, though? Oh my god, I have like 20% more morale than them.
Nice.
They have better discipline, but still, they just stack wipe themselves on me.
Nice.
A 20, like a 20 stack. Wow. Get fudged on, you know. Yeah, the game is definitely chugging along a little bit, but you know, what do you expect?
Not for me, but I mean, I'm the host.
So. Yeah, it's not. It's honestly not that bad, though. I have a colonist, darn it! Oh, I always forget. Where should I colonize next? I mean, probably somewhere good, I guess. I guess I'll colonize a little bit more Brazil, honestly. Why not? You guys, hey, hop back on the boats. We're going back over to our country, the other side of the Mediterranean. Oh, this is brutal. We're gonna surprise them.
Protect our brethren in Breda. I'll get to that. I should probably like not be at war for just a couple years though. Let's get my aggressive expansion. Minus 76 with Denmark. Mm-hmm. Minus 75 with Bavaria. Minus 76. No, that's still Denmark. And that's still Bavaria. So really only Denmark and Bavaria are the pissed off about my expansion.
Yeah. Nice. I think I might just like take Rome and Naples.
I have a bigger army than Denmark. I would take Rome.
Well, I mean, like, but I might take Rome and Naples and just deal with a coalition.
Nice.
How much would... Let's see. There would be a lot of people that would join. Let's just say... Okay, no. Not if Hungary would join.
And yeah, Denmark. That's a little scary.
Hungary and Denmark? Probably not.
What did I say I was going to spend money on?
Especially because I'm not... It's not ticking down at all for me. I'm already at, like, minimum.
Ah, upgrading forts. That's right. Buildings. Especially, I should put, like, a level 4 fort in my capital, probably. You know, just maybe.
Okay. Yeah, that might be good.
Yeah, let's turn off fort maintenance.
Okay, there we go.
My capital this entire time has been sitting with just a level 1 fort.
Nice.
For being a capital. Not exactly what you want. And I have 3 armies now. Not all the same size, but they'll get there.
Apparently... Oh, the Pope is still in that other war with France. That helps, actually.
It does help, yeah.
But Savoy isn't. Savoy is annoying me greatly.
My leaders are... I feel like they're living forever, which is okay, I guess.
I hope this one lives forever. 3-5-6 would be nice. I am going to disinherit my heir, though. Like, right now. I have 58 prestige, so it's not that big a deal.
I wish I could do it. I wish I could.
Especially now I have a French consort queen, whatever. It's nice.
I could increase my air support by 50, but that would only get him to 60, and Austria's support is at 83. So,
yeah.
Why not marry to Austria? I am. I'm still trying to figure out what this interface is exactly telling. Austria has no legal heir. Oh. What is this? Pretender rebels in... Oh, that's my vassal. I guess, yeah, I'll go help him.
Even with just taking Rome, Holland and Tuscany could join a coalition. But, like, I'm gonna
Holland's
do it.
A one-province minor in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
So,
and Tuscany is a two-province minor in Italy.
So tell me if you're scared.
Yeah, no, I'm not really. But I am scared of doing Rome and Naples. That would be suicidal.
Yeah,
almost.
That's...
I could probably take, like, Umbrian or something, but I don't really care to, honestly.
Naples isn't big, are they?
The no. province of Naples is big.
Oh, the province of Naples. Oh, okay, I get it.
29 development. Yeah. It's quite large. Yeah. Because for some reason, well, Rome conquered Naples, which also pissed me off because I didn't want that. I wanted to eat it separately, but...
Yo! I mean, this is, probably isn't going to happen because their leader is 20 years... But if Austria's leader were to die right now, their succession war...
Between who? You're cutting out a bit on Discord.
Sorry. If Austria's ruler died right now, there would be a succession war between me and Salerno.
Oh.
And nice. I'm pretty positive I could beat the shit out of Salerno.
Also, we went like 10 minutes over, so we should end this video here.
No, that's fine. Not 10, it's like 5 minutes.
Yeah, that's fine. All right, well, thank you guys for watching. Please go ahead and leave a like and subscribe for more. You know, come back next episode and we'll continue with some more of the multiplayer mini campaign. So we'll see you guys then. Bye-bye. Bye.